All right, guys, here we have a 2000, oh, I'm sorry. This is a 1994 Club Car DS. I already have the camera set up to see what we need to do. This is a no crank situation. I apologize about the background noise. I have the shop fan running because it is almost 100 degrees outside, literally. I know this is probably the first video that I've gotten to even record this year. I apologize for that. I know you guys are probably expecting some videos earlier and throughout the year, but due to the pandemic and all the crap going on, it has been extremely busy and I have not been able to take the time to record a video, so I do apologize about that. But things have pretty much died off right now, so I have enough time to get a couple of recorded videos and get them edited and uploaded to YouTube so you guys can enjoy it. So back to the cart. 94 Club Car DS. This one is a no crank situation, and I think I've already diagnosed it as a bad solenoid. Just for giggles here, I'm going to put it into service mode. Okay, make sure it's in neutral. Let's disengage the brake. I'm going to shut the fan off, just so that way you can hear what's going on. Okay, so this is a common issue with these things, with pretty much any golf cart. So I'm assuming the solenoid is bad because it's doing the click, no crank thing. And I've rotated it, rolled over the engine by hand, and it did nothing. So let's see here. So you can hear that the solenoid is clicking, but it's not doing anything. So one thing that you can do to test to see if your brushes are failing is step on the pedal and it still clicks, and then just roll the engine over by hand a little bit just to kind of get it to move past maybe a flat spot in the armature, and then step on the pedal again. And if it does nothing, it's a good chance that your solenoid is shot. But we're gonna diagnose that right now. What we're gonna do is take our voltmeter, multimeter. We're going to set it for the 20 volt range DC. We're then going to take a 5/16 nut driver. Depending on your cart, this may vary. May not be. I've seen no screws at all. So as you can see in here, we have, here is our solenoid right here, or contactor is what they're also known as. Let's see if I can find a ground point in here. Well, pretty much anywhere on the frame, or you can touch. See if I can touch a battery terminal here. Oh, there it is. Okay. Now you kind of have to have three arms to do this. Let's see if I could put this in so you can see what it's doing. And then we're gonna take our positive terminal. We're just gonna check for voltage. The red cable on this large terminal of the solenoid is directly from the battery. Okay, so we have 12.8 volts. And the white cable goes to the starter generator. So we're gonna put the probe on that side while keeping the negative on the negative battery terminal and click it. Okay, so we have 12.7 volts. Okay, so that tells me that the solenoid is good. And just to verify that, I don't recommend this unless you really know what you're doing. I'm gonna take, okay. So I'm basically jumping out the solenoid. There's little sparks, but it's not rotating the engine over. So that tells me that the solenoid is good. So we have a problem with the starter generator, which is back there. What I want to do is I want to look inside this boot on this brush right here. I just want to see what the condition of the brushes are. Let's see if we have any obvious signs of any type of damage. Looks like our armature looks cooked. Our commutator, I think it's a commutator. That's the part that the brushes touch. Okay, so let's see. I don't see any arcing out in there. I'm just trying to look for obvious things first before we. So I'm gonna rotate the motor over with the pedal pressed. You got to be very careful that it doesn't start on you while you're stepping on that. This looks like an OEM starter generator. The armature or commutator inside the motor, the electric motor, looks toast. So I have a feeling we're going to be putting a new starter generator in this puppy. Okay, so what I'm going to do, take our voltmeter, and then we're going to negative probe. Wish I had alligator clips for this meter, but I don't. We're going to put on the negative battery terminal. I just kind of wedge it in here between the battery cable and the post. Hopefully it will stay. Actually, let me do this. There. See, does that work? That works. Okay. All right, so let's try this. What I want to see is if we have power here. So I'm going to go right to the brush. Actually, I'm going to go to this screw here. I think that's the negative side anyway. Is that the negative side? Yeah, that's the negative one. Whoops. Okay. It actually smells burnt. Let's see if we have power here at the cable. Okay. So we actually don't have... Let's just check our meter again. Make sure we have... Oh, all right. So never mind. Ignore what I just said. The meter let go. All right. So let's see. All right, let's try the positive. I'm only getting 7 volts. Let's try to stab that a little better. Okay, now I'm getting full battery voltage. Okay, so we have a bad starter generator. Instead of trying to diagnose this thing on the cart, let's get it out, and then we'll go from there. I know this is a really difficult angle for you guys to see. All right, so we're gonna start with a 9/16. Actually backed out pretty smoothly. Okay, so what I'm going to do actually before we go any further is I'm going to put the cover back on the solenoid control box here since we don't really need it anymore. I know you can't see what I'm doing. I'm just putting the cover back on the control box. Okay, I had to turn the fan back on because it is just getting sweltering in here. Let's see if we can get this one off. I could actually hold on to that without using a wrench, which is nice. Will that come out of there? That one's a little tight. Okay, now we just got to get that half-inch bolt. This is basically the adjuster. The problem with these carts is you can't really work on them with the back seat. See, the other thing too, you can push on this lip here and get this access panel to open without taking out the pegs, which is kind of nice. I'm also trying out this new camera mount. It's allowing me to clamp the camera to pretty much any surface. So we'll see how that works. If I get frustrated with it, I'll go back to my GorillaPod mount. Okay, I can't get in there with that. I know it's really difficult to see what exactly it is I'm doing. Apologize for that. So down in here, my hand is right here. You see this carriage bolt right there? There's a half inch nut. It should be a half inch nut on the other side of that. And that's to loosen the adjuster. Oh, it is. Oh, good, it is a half inch. Sometimes some guys will get in here and they won't have that, or they'll drop it or something. And apologies about my arm being in the way, but I gotta get it off. And they'll change out that nut and put something that they can just find if they drop it or lose it or whatever, which, you know, it happens. Not saying there's anything wrong with it, but the Just my finger. All right, so now we got that bolt came out. I probably should have left those in. Okay, so now that the starter generator is loose, let's see if we can. Nope, that's still pretty tight. It's unusual that it's this tight, but I think there's a lock washer on there, which there should be. Usually you want to undo this nut first before taking out the two bolts that hold the starter generator on the bracket. It just keeps the starter generator from biting your fingers. You see, I don't know if you could see it now, but let's see here. That's what I'm gonna do. That was kind of a dumb move on my part, but hey, you'll have this. Let's see if I can put this back in, put a nut on it just to kind of help hold it up. I know it's impossible to see what I'm doing. All right, so the nut is loose. It's a 1/4-20, I believe. Ow. There we go. And there is a lock washer, or a split washer, whatever you want to call it, on there. Bad boy just does not want to come apart. It is not cooperating with me in the least. All right, so we'll put that back on there just for a moment. Okay, I got the split washer. Carriage bolt is coming out. Not without a fight though. Wow. Okay, well, there's a split washer and the carriage bolt. Just a standard carriage bolt. Okay, now I can take that out. Take this nut back off that I put on here. And then we'll see if we can slide this out without pinching our fingers. There we go. Okay, so the starter generator is unbolted from the cart now. Now would be a good time to probably emphasize that you should make sure you disconnect one of the battery cables. If you already haven't. All right, so our next step is going to be to disconnect the wires. In fact, these steps are all interchangeable. You don't necessarily have to do these wires and then bracket and then whatever. It's just the goal in the end is to get this thing out. These are rusted and they may break off. Go nice and slow here. They're 10 millimeter. Oh yeah, they are really. Let's see here. I don't know if you can see that. You can see how that nut and stud are just bad. Put this up here. Maybe this will help. Can this show more? I don't know. Not really, but hey, it's doing the best I can with the crap I got, guys. All right, let's see. Let's try to get the ground off. I don't know if we're going to be able to. The ground strap is not broken. I don't think we're gonna be able to, ooh, there we go. I don't think we're gonna be able to salvage this starter. We'll probably change it out for a Reliance or an AMD starter. Okay. Okay, there's that. All right, ground strap's off, that's good. That's one down. The only other one we have to get now is the DF, which is the charge circuit, and this positive. I'm trying to go slow. I really don't want to break the stud off. I can hear you screaming to use penetrating oil. I try not to because I don't want that crap getting down in the motor. Oh, there we go. Okay, good. All right, it's binding up a little bit. Let's go in the opposite direction here. What you could do when you start binding up like that is you take a metal toothbrush. See if I could find mine. Little wire brush. Get on there and just kind of clean out the threads a little bit as best as you can. Again, I'm not using penetrating oil or WD-40 or anything because I don't want it getting down inside the motor. Not that it really much matters, but at this point. Okay, there we go. It's coming off with a little bit of resistance, but it's not anything that I have concern for because it's coming off. I can feel the top of the... There we go. So a little more. It's all about taking your time. Okay. This one does not have washers on it. Okay, and then there's the DF circuit there. That's the charge circuit. Yep, this is an original motor for this. And that's all it is, guys. It's just an electric DC electric motor, a series motor. It's the very small version of an electric golf cart motor. It's just not as capable as a golf cart motor, an electric golf cart motor. And this is an 8mm. This is an 8mm. Let's see. What do you think? There is another nut on the bottom that you can grab so you don't twist it. Ooh, there we go. Okay. But a little bit of pressure is all you really need. This one's gonna break off. I can feel it. Is that whole thing spinning? I can't really tell. No, it's just here. Okay, if I keep doing this, it is coming off. Like I said, I think the starter's toast. You know, I could send it out and have it, there we go. I could have it probably milled and rebuilt and all that stuff. But by the time you get done doing all that, you could just replace it. Okay. That's off. All right, let's try to get this puppy out of here now. Which way do we want to go with it? I don't think I'll get it out that way. Let's see. See if we can get it out this way. Yeah, we got it out this way. There we go. Okay, so I want to show you something interesting that I'm seeing here. I don't know how well this is going to show up on camera. You can see that brush has a lot of life left to it. It's not stuck, but it did get hot. Okay. Same with this one. Wish I had a pick. This one here, it's not stuck in the carrier. See, but you can see down in there. I hope you can see down in there. See how that carrier in the back there that I'm lighting up is all, it's all heat checked, it's all purple and blue. Even the commutator is all purple and blue. So it's gotten quite hot, and you can see it is wore out pretty well. I don't know if this is really showing up on camera at all, but let's try this. No. It's definitely hard to show, but it does look like it's gotten quite hot, and it is pretty much wore out. There's a bunch of corrosion in there too. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this cap off just to kind of get in there a little better. First, I'll take it over to the door and I'm going to blow it out with the air compressor. And then we'll take this cap off on the vise and we'll see what it looks like inside. So we got the starter generator over here on the bench. Let's get this end cap off so we can see what's going on with it. Just forgive my messy workbench. I've also been in the process of hearing weird noises in here. Things falling over. Been in the process of cleaning everything in the garage. Going through a lot of stuff, getting rid of a lot of stuff. It's been a challenge. Didn't notice this end cap doesn't sit on here quite well. Get that out. In the way. So in the process of cleaning everything, all the little things that I don't have a home for yet end up on the bench, and they just get piled up and piled up. And then with all the virus stuff going on, it's made it a little bit challenging to get it all put away, because work has been extremely busy, only because everybody's coming to the area to escape the city. Because of that, everybody comes in all at once, and at the same time of trying to get golf carts returned from winter storage, it's just a nightmare. And the focus on the camera is not exactly great this time around, because I don't have my regular lens on here that I normally have. I don't know what I did with it. Okay, here we go. It's getting a little... See, even the, I don't know if you can see that, even the grease inside there's a little burnt. But you can see actually these are not moving as freely as I originally thought they were. Well, you know what we might be able to do? It's not that bad. The ridge, I mean, it looks burnt. I mean, there's no question. I mean, what I can try to do to save the customer some money up right now is we can sand this commutator. It's got a lip on it. I mean, it looks like it's the original starter for the cart. And it's a 94, and I don't know how much they're going to want to really invest. I'm going to ohm out each coil, though, and make sure they're not shot. But I can tell already, just by the insulation being broken off, all the wires here, that this got hot at one point. And they're not sliding in and out of here as easily as I originally thought. Let's try this. I mean, they're getting stuck. This one here is getting stuck. But I think that's just a matter of a clearance issue with the wires. So let's try something here. There's supposed to be a sheath on this. Let me just get a little closer look here. I want to try to save the customer a little bit of money, if it's practical, of course. Yeah, see, this is just not sliding like it should. It's binding on something. I mean, I could try to file it, see what happens. See, this one's moving pretty good. It's hanging though, see? It's gotten hot in here. Look at this one's hanging too. You can see a little bit of schmeg on there. Okay, let's take the brushes off and we'll sand the brushes a little bit, and I'll see if I can get in there with the microfile and clean that up. Okay, we're gonna start by what I'm doing. I know it's hard to see what I'm doing. I'm right-handed and I got the camera on the wrong side. I'm taking the screwdriver and lifting that spring off the brush and trying to hold it back while at the same time trying to push the brush out. Wire is just not flexible anymore. Let's get another screwdriver just for that purpose. So I'm going to hold the spring back, grab that, there we go. That's a lot easier. I'm not going to unscrew the brush from the mount. I might straighten them out a little bit because they're not really sat in here very well. Okay, so there we go. And remember, these have pinholes. Well, there's one there, and then there's a corresponding pin on the starter generator. The tab only goes on one way. I mean, you can't misalign it. At least the back one you can't. At least it shouldn't. Let's see here. See, we can see some scoring on this. I'm just gonna take this file and lightly clean it. Not gonna go nuts with it, just get any high spots. Anywhere that it may have caught. See where it was arcing a little bit on the commutator. Oh, it feels a little better. And these are just carbon brushes. I mean, there's nothing really super fancy about them. So you see here is where it's got a little hung up from getting hot. So I'm hoping that this allows them to slide in and out of their carrier a little better. Might even hit the edge of this one here a little. And then you can see that line right here, that's the wear mark. Once the brush hits that point, it's time to replace them. See that score mark right there? That's probably where it got hot. Now you can see there's a little bit of a nick right there. Hopefully you can see that. I'm just gonna see that burn hole right there? It's smooth. That's the goal. If this doesn't work, then we'll have to go to the route of replacing the starter generator. Because it's possible it could have overheated the windings. I'm hoping it didn't. Yeah, you can see it. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but right here. A little bit of pitting. Okay, one more. And then we'll get some sandpaper. I believe I have aluminum oxide sandpaper. See, this one didn't get that hot because the sheath is still there. It's crunchy though, so it's quite possible that it did. My fingers are all shiny. And there's really nothing that you can put on the brushes to clean them. I mean, like, you know, to keep them free from getting stuck. At least there's nothing that I know of. I'm not a motor expert, electric motor expert, and I don't claim to be. I just do what I think I can do, make it right. This is just a quick okay. Whoop, hit the camera. Sorry about that. Let's put that in there. See how that, oh, much better. That's like butter now. Yeah, that's way better. That's operating like it should. I'm gonna have to take them back out to get this end cap back on anyway. So here's what I'm doing, trying to get my fat hand out of the way. There's the carrier slot. I'm just hitting it really quick on the long, wide edges just to make sure there's no little boogers in there. See if it slides easily. Yep, so there goes that sheath. Oh, like butter. Okay, so what you can do, like if you have this end cap off and you put the brushes in, to get them to seat, so you can put this end cap back on the motor, you can slide the brush out and get it to the point where the spring is resting on the face. But make sure that when you push that out, it's there, that's even better. See, I don't know if you can see that clearly. See how the spring is just pushing on the face? That'll give you enough momentum to basically put the brush carrier back into the electric motor and not worry about boogering up these brushes, because you don't want to booger the brushes or anything else for that matter. Okay, let's try to get you in here for this one. This one looks like it got hot because it's discolored. And these are electrically isolated. And it, like I said, this is just something we're going to try and see if it works. If it doesn't work, then at least we can say we tried. See, this one's not moving as easily as I think it should. We're going to adjust this. Okay. Rotate this out this way a little bit more. Oh, that's better. Much better. We'll make sure they're all good and tight too. That one looks like it got hot. Don't ask me where I got this file. I have no idea. It was in a toolbox that was given to me. Yeah, that's like butter. Like butter. Okay, so I'm going to gently push till the spring locks it open. There we go. Let me wipe out that grease with a paper towel here. I don't want to introduce any lubricants or contaminants in here. I'm just going to try to wipe it out as best as I can. Again, I could probably send this motor out and have it properly cleaned and rebuilt. But by the time you get into it, you can really, you could just replace the damn thing. There's almost no sense in doing that. Okay. Got most of it out. Looks better. Nice and clean. All right, now let's try to sand that. I'm gonna wipe that bearing off too. That's got a bunch of crap on it. I have electronics cleaner too, so we'll clean this up with that. All right, so what we're gonna do to clean this, I'm not gonna use any paper, sandpaper on it. I'm just gonna use a little bit of contact cleaner and a plastic toothbrush, because like I said, I don't really wanna cause any significant, I don't wanna damage this part. But look at that, just that little bit of cleaning is already. Yes, you could, ooh, knocked over the light. You could take this to a motor shop, probably, and have them turn it on a lathe or whatever, whatever they do. But in all reality, in this situation, is it really worth it? I don't think it is, but that's just my opinion. I'm just gonna try this first. Because what if reseating them brushes didn't do squat? You know what I mean? That could just be, we could just be, as a friend of mine always says, ooh, the shit evaporates really quick. Could just be pissing into the wind. And when you do that, your leg gets wet. So we're gonna try this first. Is it the right way? No, probably not. But like I said before in the video, I don't claim to be an expert on how to clean electric motors. It's actually not bad. Touching it with my dirty, greasy fingers like an idiot. These things are so cheap anyway. All right, let's put it back together. I know you guys are probably screaming at the monitor. You should have it returned and blah, blah, blah. I know, I understand that. Okay, just to let you know, here is the pin, the dowel, basically, that coincides with the hole right there. It looks like it's bent. See if we can straighten that out first. Hopefully it won't break off. There we go. Okay, well, it's a little better. So now this should just slip right back on. I am going to use the hammer and just tap it gently. There, it's going nice and smooth. Okay. That pin. Oop. It's not. Okay. I think we need to pull this back off. Okay, yeah, it's not lining up correctly for some reason. Probably doesn't help that it's all bent up. Let's try to bend it back a little more. Okay. Oop, I had a brush pushed back. Again, guys, we're just trying this. All right, we're gonna see what happens here. We're gonna see if this is gonna work at all. Like I said at the beginning of this video, I don't claim to be an electric motor expert in the least. Okay. See if that pin, it is lined up with the hole. Let's tap this in. Okay, hear that solid bottoming out. That's good. Let me just check in here. Okay, that pin's got a little bit of a twist to it, so I just gotta go around and not too hard because you don't want to break anything. I don't think I worked on this cart before, or at least I didn't work on this starter generator before, so hopefully this will work. We'll see. It's going to be interesting to see it work. If it does, it might not last a long time, but we'll figure it out. See, that's why I took my time too with taking those contact nuts off. Push those in. That's pretty satisfying, actually. Ready? Here, I'm going to use a screwdriver so you can see it. Hopefully you can see it. Click. That's very satisfying, I gotta say. Okay, now we'll put our link wire back on. Let's bump it. Let's bump this one too, just to make sure, okay? All right, so what I'm gonna do now is we're gonna ohm this thing out just because. I know you're not gonna be able to really see this, but see if we have any. Look at that. That's negative and positive. So we have a series circuit. See if we're grounded to the frame here. How about the DF circuit? I wish this had auto. Okay, let's throw this bad boy in the cart. It's nothing's grounded to the chassis, so we're good. Let's throw it in the cart and see what happens. Actually, I'm gonna put these caps back on first. And the reason I was ohming it to make sure it wasn't grounding out was to make sure these wires didn't accidentally hit the framework. Let's go drop this puppy back in the cart and see what happens.
Gotta be careful we don't break those electrical studs off, that's all.
All right, so what I'm gonna do first is to prevent my fingers from getting smashed. So I'm gonna put in one, get them started. No, I'm not wearing gloves on this job. Do you notice that? Okay. All right, so what I'm gonna do before I even go through the process of tightening everything down is I'm gonna see if the starter generator will actually crank over, or well, turn on first of all, before I go through the trouble of putting all this stuff back together. And I'm not gonna put the motor on it, or the belt on it rather, I am just going to hook up the power cables and tighten them down so they're snug, so we don't have any, you know, large gaps or loose wires and cause excessive heat. Step on the pedal and see if it spins or lets out the magic smoke. If it spins, then I'll put the belt on and adjust it and see if the cart starts. Okay. And I'm not even gonna torque these down all the way until I make sure. Okay. Let's see what happens. Key on. Look at that. It spins. See, there's the pulley. Look at that. So that's good news, right? I want to get before I hook everything else up, I want to get this adjuster bolt in place. Okay, I'll get the nut and washer started on it, so that way all I gotta do is tighten it up. Once I actually get the belt back on. In fact, I am going to pivot this up so I could actually get to it. I get that belt lined up on the pulley correctly of the drive clutch. I'm gonna take a nice 1-inch wrench here and see if I can get it in. There we go. Put some nice tension on that belt. I'm gonna use a 13 millimeter ratchet wrench to tighten this up, since I have to use one hand to keep tension. On the starter generator. Yes, I still have to tighten up the pivot bolts. They're not a big deal. At least that being tight, I don't have to worry about the belt tension. It'll tighten up as I tighten these up, so that's not a worry. I'll adjust and tighten up the electrical. Wrong way. Okay. There we go. There we go. See how that works? When you know your tools, you know when to stop. All right. What I want to do is just kind of readjust my electrical connections here, because I need the light. I know you can't see what I'm doing. I have to get this ground wire in a location where it's not gonna bind up on anything. Okay, power is tight. Now I just need my yellow cable, which ran away from me here. That's on. Boy, it is still really hot outside. Okay, that's tight. Now I can push the access panel back into its position. Didn't even have to take the pegs out, which is great. We're in service mode, key is on. That's fantastic news, the cart starts. And it started right up without even touching the choke. So now what I'm gonna do is put the meter on it, and I wanna make sure that it's actually charging correctly. Club Car and their infinite wisdom decided that the positive terminal was suited best closest to the metal frame that is a negative ground. All right, I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to see this or not. Once I get the damn clamp on the battery, let's see here. Okay, so you can see we are up near 14 volts. What we're looking for is it to climb and level off. Let's see here. Wow. That ain't good. I think he might have a bad voltage regulator. Let's try the fancy meter. Output cable check complete. Battery volts, let's see, 13.8. Press enter. We're going to do a battery test. Battery flooded. Cranking amps, 550. Actually, it's 560. My bad. 560. Enter. Above 32 degrees Fahrenheit, 0C, yes. Surface charge, test in vehicle, yes. Turn on headlights for 15 seconds. Oh boy, does this have headlights? Yes, it does. Okay, so I turned the headlights on, so now it's gonna count down. It's a little tricky to test golf cart batteries like this because they're not the same electrically as cars, but as far as the load goes, they're not the same. What does that say? Turn off headlights, press enter. Headlights off, press enter, testing. All right, what do we have? Good and pass. 651 cold cranking amps and 12.87 volts. We're gonna print the results. See, this is a nice feature now to have. I'm able to test these batteries and I'm gonna test the charging system too. We're gonna go to system test, turn off loads, start engine. Let's see how well this works, because this is not exactly the same as starting a car. I don't know. Still says turn off loads, start engine. Let's see. There we go. Cranking volts, 13.5. We're gonna test the charging system. All idle volts high, 16.5. Turn on loads. Headlights are on. Ripple detected normal. Alternator volts high. Okay, so we got a bad voltage. Well, I don't know if we have a bad voltage regulator yet. Okay, test over, turn off this stuff, that thing. All right, so now we're gonna print these results on top of the same page. This way I can give them this slip. Okay. I know club cars charge high. Here, I'm gonna kind of give you guys a sneak peek at this. I know they do have a high charging voltage. They do charge around 15, maybe more, volts. I put this my meter on 20 volts. I just wanna see what this reads, because that load meter, I don't really 100% trust that, because you never know. 13.62 volts on the meter. All right, so I'm thinking that I think we have a bad voltage regulator. We cannot let that go like that. The one I have in stock for this is this larger one, which I don't understand that, but whatever, it is what it is, I guess. First of all, we gotta cut some zip ties out of the way. Pair of dykes. Somebody gave me flack for calling these dykes because it was a derogatory word used towards lesbian women. Well, guess what? They're called dykes because they're diagonal cutters. It has nothing to do with your accusation. I don't care either way about anybody's lifestyle. You choose to love who you want to love. I don't care. Okay, so now we have... Okay, we have to take the battery terminal off. Let's unplug the starter generator. I'm an easy kind of going person, folks. I don't judge anybody for anything. All right, so that's from the starter generator. Let's unhook the power and then... Actually, you know what I gotta do? I gotta get that out first. I believe that's a 7/16 or 11 millimeter. They're close enough. Nice and slow. There we go. This way I could remove it. Now the new one is not gonna fit in here the same way, unfortunately, because it is physically larger, which I absolutely hate that. Why? I do. I hate that when parts don't match their original size. All right, so on these voltage regulators, you have three wires, almost four. So the yellow wire comes from the starter generator's charging circuit output. The positive side goes to the positive terminal on the solenoid, so the battery side of the solenoid. And we got a single ground lead that comes out that splits off to two. One goes to a ground stud that's located in the control box or just outside the control box, depending on the year. And the spade terminal that goes to the micro switch in the control box, which is basically the grounding switch. So this basically acts like double duty, this wire. No, actually this will make this easier by doing, we're just gonna remove the solenoid, move the solenoid. We're not gonna disconnect any wires yet. We're gonna do that last. See, they have an hour meter connected to the starter generator side of the solenoid. So when the starter generator is activated or energized, it runs the volt or the hour meter, and it's a genuine club car part, so it's not like an aftermarket add-on or anything. Okay. Now what this is going to allow me to do, if I can carefully move this over and this over without shorting anything out, it's going to allow me to get down in here and break loose that one nut, 7/16 nut down here. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. Well, maybe. Is there a... Nope, that's a captive nut. Let's see, let's try, oh, you know what, I think it's, why is it not breaking loose? Let's disconnect the positive. Oh. Positive terminal on solenoid, so I can remove that voltage regulator wire, and then we'll put the battery cable back on that so we don't destroy anything, short anything out, basically. Okay, there's that, there's that, there's that. Okay, yeah, see, that looks like that was spliced in there. I should not be spinning with that nut. Gonna have to keep pulling that out of there every time it binds up the wires, and then I'll have to straighten out that situation because I really have no idea. Oh, looks like it just broke a wire, because I honestly have no idea why these wires are rotating with that nut. And one of them is a chassis ground, so I'll have to figure that out. There. Oh, now they stopped. They got caught around something and stopped rotating with the... Yeah, see, look at how they twist it up. Okay, this, see, this one here is basically the other hoop of... Well, we're going to take that crap out of there and we're going to install it right. There's the ring terminal that broke. And then this one's the one that goes over to the chassis ground. Oh, I see what was happening. There's a jam nut on the bottom. It looks like that was spinning with the whole entire thing. So we're gonna crank that down tight so it can't do it again. This is not the right size voltage regulator for this cart physically, but I guess we can... Not going to be able to bolt it in. That's the problem. I don't like doing this, but I'm kind of stuck. All right, so we're going to put this ground tab on here. And now I'll take this. And now I'm going to use the electric to tighten it down or to get it to spin faster. Now that I got that kind of sorted out, and then I'll plug that wire into the switch. I would like to keep all of this stuff on this side of the control box. Okay, that stopped. Now I'll turn it by hand. All right, now it's tight. Now I'll take this, and this spade connector goes into the bottom switch, center connector. Basically, when this switch opens, this switch is a normally closed, it's using the normally closed terminals. So when the foot is left off the gas pedal, it goes to short the ignition out so the cart shuts off. That's what's supposed to happen anyway. Okay, so now I got my voltage regulator installed. I really hate the fact that I can't bolt this thing in, but this is the real world and this is what it is, I guess. All right, so I'm gonna take the nut off of the solenoid, off the battery terminal side. If I can get it to come off, there we go, put it on, battery terminal. This is the live battery side, so I suggest you guys, if you're doing this yourself, to unhook the battery off, the terminal off the battery, battery cable. Okay, there's that. I tuck them wires down in here. Now I just need the starter generator. Plug this in, click, stuff that wire down in there too. All right, now we'll install our nuts or bolts, screws, whatever you want to call them, onto the solenoid. What I like to do is hold the solenoid up and drop the screw into the hole. It kind of like acts like a screw guide. Line it up at the hole, get it started. Do the same thing on this side. It just makes trying to get in there into the tight area a little bit easier. Unless you have magnetic tools, which I don't. When it's already tight quarters as it is in here. And then tighten everything up. I'm going to tighten up the battery terminal on this side. Actually, that's a 9/16. They usually are half inch, but or 13 or 14 millimeter. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is turn the meter on. We're going to go battery voltage. We're in service mode, key on. I got my foot on the accelerator. See what happens. Okay. There's our result.
Idle volts 15.8 or 15.08 normal. Turn on loads. Headlights are on. Normal ripple. Normal. Just over.
Okay. Let's print that out. And that will go along with the invoice. This meter helps a lot with a lot of different things. I am really glad I invested in this. Okay, so there we go. All right, guys, that is gonna do it for this one. We are done. We got that voltage regulator changed out. We repaired, at least I hope we repaired, the starter generator. We'll see how long that goes for. Put our cart back into run mode so when I load it up, drive it out of here, I can get it up on the trailer. That's pretty much it for this. So I wanna thank you guys for watching. I really do appreciate it as always. Be sure to go down and check the video's description for links to products that I use to bring you these videos. There's also links down below to my social media pages, webpage, and all that fun jazz. Be sure to like the video if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel if you already haven't. Leave a comment down below. And until next time, we'll see you in the next video.